Thanks, Dean. Throughout this lesson and others, Dean will give us more advice and discuss the big picture when doing EDA. For now, let's start by loading up some data. You can find a data file in the instructor notes. This data file contains all the Facebook data that we're going to be looking at. To load up the data, let's first make sure that we're in the right directory. Here's my current directory, and I can see that I'm in a folder that has the data sets. I can use the list.files command to figure out what files are within this directory. And here's the data set that I want, the pseudo Facebook data set. To read in the data set, I'm going to use the read.csv command. But I need to be a little bit careful. I need to indicate that the separator is really a tab, and that's because we're working with a tab-separated values file. Running the command, I can see that I get my data set up in R. Now, this data set is similar to the kind that data scientists see from time to time at Facebook, and it's especially the type of data that they'll use when doing EDA. This file has approximately 99,000 rows or observations in it with 15 variables. Each observation represents a user, and that user will have different information, such as their age, their name, or their date of birth. We can see all these variables by running the names command. Now, in this entire process, our goal is to understand our user's behavior and their demographics. We want to understand what they're doing on Facebook and what they use. This is why you see things like friend count, WW likes, and mobile likes. We created this dataset specifically for this course to have many features common to such user-level behavioral and demographic data. But I need to say that this data isn't actual Facebook data. So not all statistics in this dataset are going to be accurate representations of how people use Facebook on a day-to-day basis. So our lawyers want me to make the disclaimer that this isn't actual data from Facebook users. But we did use a complex model to generate it, and I think we can learn some very interesting things about it.